everyone and welcome to Indian Masterminds, a show where we showcase excellence in bureaucracy. This is election season, and to celebrate the biggest festival of democracy, we are presenting to you a bouquet of bureaucrats who crossed over the thin line dividing the executive and the legislature. This is Muskan Khandelwal, and today we are presenting to you an IAS officer who first delivered Karnataka to Congress, then he managed Telangana. Now he is not only managing Congress's national election war room, but he is also contesting himself as Congress candidate from Tiruvallur, the northernmost constituency in Tamil Nadu. He is 2009 batch IAS officer of Karnataka cadre, Sasikant Senthil. Senthil was two batches senior to IPS officer K. Annamalai, also of Karnataka cadre. Annamalai is now Tamil Nadu state BJP president, and like Senthil, he is also contesting from Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu. Senthil, unlike Annamalai, is very quiet and low-profile person. Senthil was born on June 15, 1985 in Bangalore to Justice P. Shanmugam, a retired district judge, and Mrs. Ambika Shanmugam, a retired central government officer. He graduated in electronics from the Bharatidasan University. He worked in a software company called Polaris, and later he quit his job to pursue civil services. From 2009 through 2012, he served as assistant commissioner in Bellamy district. He served for two terms as chief executive officer of Shimoga Zilla Panchayat. He served as the deputy commissioner of Chitradurg district and later at Raichur district. His stint as Raichur DC during 2013-14 also paid dividends for Congress, as he succeeded in drawing some of the key local leaders into the party. He also played a role in bringing several SC left leaders into the Congress fold from the BJP. Senthil was appointed as the director in the Department of Mines and Geology, to be shifted soon as the deputy commissioner of Dakshin Kannada district. As a deputy commissioner, he managed communal conflicts efficiently and worked on the sand mafia. His administration succeeded in cutting the funds provided to religious extremism organizations. He held discussions with members of various religious communities to instill self-confidence. There were 42 cases and 6 instances of communal violence at South Kannada in 2017. It fell to 3 cases and 3 instances of communal conflagration in 2018. Despite his tough stand against right-wing elements, Senthil's stint as the Dakshin Kannada DC from June 2017 to September 2019 was appreciated by a section of the BJP workers for his pro-people moves and his stern action against the nexus of sand mafia and their political masters. His handling of floods earned him respect among people, with frequent school holidays announced by him during the rains made children fond of him. He resigned from the IAS in September 2019 when he was district collector of Dakshin Kannada district. He then said it was unethical for him to continue in his line of duty as a civil servant in the government when the fundamental building blocks of our diverse democracy were being compromised in an unprecedented manner. I also feel strongly that the coming days will present extremely difficult challenges to the basic fabric of our nation, and I would be better off outside the IAS to continue with my work at making life better for all, he said. Subsequently, Senthil, who was a staunch critic of the Narendra Modi-led BJP government's Citizen Amendment Act, CAA, a National Register of Citizens, NRC proposal, travelled across the country to interact with people and activists protesting against them. In November 2020, Senthil joined the Congress in the presence of senior Tamil Nadu party leader K.S. Alagiri and then AICC General Secretary Dinesh Gundurao. He said he has always worked for the welfare of the people and will continue to do so. I left the civil service in search of a method to send the totalitarian attack on the country I dearly love, he said. Initially, Senthil worked with the Congress's training vertical. In the 2021 Tamil Nadu Assembly elections, He worked at the party's war room in Chennai. As the party was impressed by his work, he was entrusted with the task of liaising between Rahul Gandhi and civil society members during the three-week Karnataka leg of his Bharat Jodo Yatra in September-October. This brought him close to Rahul. The Congress appointed Senthil the head of its Karnataka war room, keeping in view his deep insight into its politics. Senthil and his team worked day and night to devise the campaigns and social media strategies for the Congress. He conceptualized campaigns like 40% Commission Sarkar and Pay CM against the then Chief Minister Basavaraj Bommai of BJP in Karnataka. These campaigns soon became part of a not only statewide poll discourse, but found traction at national level. His team worked not only to counter BJP's polarizing narrative, but also formed its own narratives. Senthil had a strong team of about 50 members, some of whom came from Chennai and Nagpur. They also worked to help the Congress formulate its statements and choose places for its events and rallies. Following his success in Karnataka State Assembly elections in March 2023, he was also made in charge of Congress campaign in Telangana Assembly elections in October-November last year. Here too, he was successful in wrestling the state from Telangana Rashtra Party. In January this year, he was appointed chairman of Congress's Central War Room in New Delhi for Lok Sabha elections. Senthil has been active socially. He has built a library in his native village in Tamil Nadu with his salary and helped many poor students in his native village to get education. I have been an activist trying to be a voice for the poor, less privileged and the most marginalized in the society all through my life, wherever I was and would continue the same, he says. Despite his busy political engagements, he has consistently been monitoring the UPSC aspirants. Join us next time as we unravel more stories of bureaucrats who have shaped our country. Our next video will be on Aparajita Sarangi, a former IAS officer and sitting member of parliament from Bhubaneswar. She is seeking a second term in Lok Sabha. Until then, I'm Muskan Khandelwal signing off. Stay informed, stay curious and stay tuned. And don't forget to keep tracking the Lok Sabha elections with Indian Masterminds. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get instant alerts.